Amber, it's fantastic to have you tonight. What was it about this screening that made you want to come along and be a part of it?
So the first thing that attracted me to this film, I saw the trailer without knowing who was attached to it, and I just thought this seems like a story that needs to be told, and I really want to watch it. And then I saw it was directed by Sean Cronin, and the last film that I did was directed by Sean, and he cast me in the lead female role, and I was like, well, I wanted to see it anyway, but like supporting fellow independent filmmakers is really, really important to me, and I just thought I can't not be there. So I was planning on coming anyway, and then I got invited, and I thought, well, this is fate.
Obviously, this is a film that tells a story that deals with a lot of important and sensitive subject matter, disability, class discrimination. Can you talk about why it's particularly important for cinema to tackle those sorts of issues?
Yeah, so I think anything that's to do with discrimination, whether it's the matters that you mentioned or anything to do with, you know, gender or ethnicity, people need to tell these stories and address it in film, because I feel like then it's getting out to such a wider audience, and there's so many problems out there that people try to push under the carpet and pretend like it's not an issue. But when you're seeing people dealing with these problems on film, I feel like it makes it more real. And even if it's something that you might not have experienced in your own life, you connect with the characters on screen, you empathize with them, and then you start to realize it is a real problem, and hopefully then people can change their actions in their own life to help others.
Obviously, this is a festival that above all celebrates storytelling. I'm curious why you're a storyteller and why you think stories matter so much in all our lives.
Yeah, so I think for me, when I first wanted to become an actor, it was when I watched Titanic. And I remember watching the film and crying at the end. And I said to my mum, why am I crying? I don't know these people. Who are these people? Why am I feeling like this? And she explained about acting and storytelling. And I just thought, that's incredible to have that power to make audiences feel so much and go on such a journey and of like learning and discovery. And I just thought, that's incredible. And it's such a gift. And I love that, being an actor, the fact that we can tell these stories and reach people all around the world. I just think it's incredible.
I cried because there was 1,000% room for Jack on that door. I'm just saying.
What? Have you not seen the diagrams? I saw one and it was two people playing poker and there was like a whole chess kit. There was plenty of space for both of them on the door, but it's fine. It's fine. In another universe, Jack survived.
He survived. He swam to shore and got an Oscar. In terms of your own work, what have you got coming up at the moment?
So the film that I've just done with Sean called Angel of the North, we've just wrapped production. I play Leanne, who is the lead character's partner, based on the true story of James McCrory. He's a bare-knuckle boxer, and it's kind of his life and journey. Such a fun shoot. Really excited for that one to come out. I also played a small role in this other film called The Art of Abuse, which is, again, a really, really important topic that needs to be told, and I'm very excited for that one to come out.